morning students. I hope you are all doing good. Let us see what we are going to discuss in today's class.
Good morning, ma. In previous class, we have seen up to D block, S block, P block, D and F, like that we have classified. Up to S, P, D we completed. In today's class, we will start with F block elements. This is total periodic table. In this periodic table, separately under the body, they kept two rows. These two rows are called F block elements, which are also called inner transition elements. That one we will get in next classification name. Okay, see, these two rows, one is containing lanthanoids and another one is containing actinoids. '58 to '71, these elements are present as lanthanoids. '90 to '103, these are actinoids. These are actually not periods, ma. Even though we wrote what horizontally, these are all containing, actually we should represent as straight line only, same group only. Lanthanoids are containing one group, actinoids are containing one group, like that only. These are not actually should be written separately. Horizontally we should not write, but so many elements are there, na? That's why they represented like that. All these 14 elements are present here. Position. See, they kept the star mark. That means lanthanides. Lanthanides position is 6th period, 3rd group. In between lanthanum and hafnium, in between lanthanum and hafnium, we have these elements. See, 57, 72, 58 to 71. So, what is the position of lanthanides? Position of lanthanides, 6th period and 3rd A group. Coming to position of actinoids, double star here, 7th period. 7th period, 3rd group. Between actinium and rutherfordium, 89, 104, see, 90 to 103, these elements must be present here. That's why D block is, sorry, 6th period is included with this 14 elements also. 14, 2, 16, 10, 26, 6, 32 elements. Coming to 7th period, 2 elements, 14 elements, 16, 10, 26. These elements, see, they are not discovered completely. 113 to 118. They are not discovered completely. And electronic configuration of lanthanides, 4F, N, actually 4F 1 to 14, ma, here 5D 0 to 1, 6S2. Actinoids, 5F 1 to 14, 6D 0 to 2, 7S2. Why we are writing here D also? I will explain before that. I hope you got one idea about F block. These two rows are combinedly called F block. One row is called lanthanides and another row is called actinides. Actually, I should not say rho, they are completely belonging as one group only. So entire 14 elements are present here between lanthanum and hafnium. Entire these 14 elements are present here. Now I told the positions also. Position of lanthanides, position of actinides. One more time I will write here. After that, why we have written electronic configuration in this way, I will explain. Okay, ma? See. Now I am going to keep the side heading F block. F block contains two rows, lanthanides and actinides. Lanthanides position is 6th period, 3rd A group. Actinides position is 7th period, 3rd A group. Both are belonging to 3rd A group only, but different periods. Okay. Now, lanthanides, general configuration. Four F 1 to 14, 5D 0 to 1, 6S 2. Actinides, 5F 1 to 14, 6D 0 to 2, 7S 2. Actually, electronic configuration of elements we have seen in structure of atom. By using Mohr's diagram, we will write the electronic configuration of all the elements. By using Mohr's diagram, we can write the electronic configuration of all the elements. But for F block, we cannot write electronic configuration by using Mohr's diagram. This is the exception case for F block. Is it okay? Why it is? Because see, this is the nucleus, first shell. Second shell. Third shell. Fourth shell. Fifth shell. When we move away from nucleus, this energy gap decreases between first shell and second shell. More energy gap is there between second shell and third shell. Energy gap decreases. Third shell to fourth shell further decreases. Fourth to fifth further decreases. Fifth to sixth further decreases. Is it correct or not? Already in structure of atom, we have seen that when we move away from nucleus, energy gap present between the orbits will be decreased. Then these 5th, 6th, almost they are coming very much closer. 1 and 2 like this, energy gap, 1 and 2 like this. 2 and 3 little bit close. 3 and 4 little bit close. 4 and 5 little bit close. 5 and 6 almost they are getting very much nearer. Okay ma, 1 2 energy gap is high, 2 and 3 energy gap somewhat reduced, 3 and 4 somewhat reduced, 4 and 5 some more they will come closer, 5 and 6 some more they will get closer. Like this, when we move away from nucleus, energy gap present between the orbits decreases. This 4 F orbitals means F block, 4F, 5D, 6S, fourth shell, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, correct, 4, 5, 6, actinides, lanthanides, ma, lanthanides shell numbers 4, 5, 6, actinides shell numbers 5, 6, 7. Actinide shell number 5, 6, 7. See, they are very far away from nucleus. Almost energy gap is very less between 5F and 6D. Energy gap is very less. 4F and 5D also energy gap is very less. Even though they are belonging to different shells, ma, energy shells are getting very closer, na, when we move away from nucleus. As energy gaps are very less, electrons, they will not follow Mollis diagram. They can enter into, some electrons, they can enter into 5D also. Without filling 4F, electrons can enter into 5D also. Because energy gap is very less. Okay, that's why F block elements, we cannot write, for F block elements, we cannot write electronic configuration by using Mollis diagram. By using X-ray diffraction techniques, scientists found particular configurations for F block elements. Okay, for example, in this periodic table, they gave the electronic configurations, ma, observe. Cerium, 4F2, 5D0, 6S2. Pr, 4F3, 5D0, 6S2. Nd, neodymium, 4F4, prolactium, this one. 4F4, 5D0, 6S2. 4F5, 5D0, 6S2. 4F6, 5D0, okay, see, observe here. Gallium, 4F7, 5D1, 6S2. Without entering that 8th electron into 4F, that electron enters into 5D0. Up to here, 0 only, 5D0. Here, 5D1. It is not following Mollis diagram. Mollis diagram means, first lower energy subshells must be filled, then only electrons should enter into next one. But here, 4F is not completely filled. Without that, electron enters into 5D. Next, 4F9. See, 8th electron, 9th electron here only, 5D0. 4F10, 5D1. 4F11, 5D0. Containing 5D0, 5D1. 5D0, 5D1. That's why they wrote 5D0 to 1. As it doesn't follow, means these actinides, they will not follow particular rule according to Mollis diagram, because energy gap between 4 and 5, 4F and 5D almost nearby each other. That's why electrons, they can enter into 5D also without entering completion of 4F. Okay, ma? Then by using X-ray diffraction techniques only, they are able to find the electronic configuration and they kept here. And lutetium, 4F14, 5D1, 6S2. So everything, hardly it is containing 5D0 or 5D1. Next, coming to actinides also, 5F0, 6D2, 7S2. See, F is not entered also. 5F0, 6D2, 2 electrons entered into 6D, 7S2. 5F2, 6D1, 7S2. 5F3, 6D1, 7S2. Like that, 6D1, initial one, 6D2 also it has shown. 6D0 also we have seen. 6D0, 6D1, 6D2. That's why they wrote 6D022. 5F1 to 14, 7S2. There is no particular rule, because energy levels are almost getting nearby each other, so electrons can enter into 6d also without completion of 5f. That's why only we are not able to write fixed configuration for these f block elements. So general configuration of lanthanides, I have shown it as 4f1 to 14, 5d0 to 1, 6s2, actinides 5f1 to 14, 6d0 to 2, 7s2. This is the information about f block. F block contains lanthanides and actinides. Lanthanides position 6th period. F block contains lanthanides and actinides. F block contains lanthanides position is 6th period and 3rd A group. Actinides position is 7th period and 3rd A group. All are metals only. This is about F block. So in previous class already we have seen the information about S block and P block. Regarding this metalloids, ma, in some textbooks astatine they included, and AS also they included. Boron they did not include. In our CBSE textbook, they did not include boron. Silicon, germanium, arsenic, strontium, tellurium, polonium, and astatine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They gave 6 metalloids. Sorry, 7 metalloids in our CBSE textbook. I will refer once IIT textbooks or NEET textbooks, and I will say regarding what are the metalloids. Once I will inform to you in next class. Okay, this is for instance I have written like this, but previously boron was also included as metalloid only. Boron, silicon, germanium, strontium, tellurium, polonium. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 are there actually. But I will check that one now. But anyways, like this, metalloids are there in between metals and non-metals. These are all non-metals, these are all metals. In between, one cross, one diagonal like that, metalloids are present. What are the metalloids? I will check that one and I will say. Okay, ma, this is P block. Next, D block also we have done in last class. And in today's class, we have done up to now regarding F block. I hope you are clear, ma. And what about next classification? Depending on chemical properties of elements, periodic table is classified into, depending on chemical properties of elements, periodic table is classified into 4 types. Those are, first one, representative elements. 2, inert gases. 3, transition elements. 4, inert transition elements. Depending on chemical properties of elements, periodic table is classified into 4 types. 1, representative elements. 2, inert gases. 3, transition elements. And 4, inert transition elements. Okay, let us see that according to type wise. First one I am going to keep side heading, representative elements. Why these are called representative elements? These elements try to get the configuration of inert gases. We know that inert gases are nothing but very highly inert in nature. That means they won't react with others. Why they are not reactive with others? Because of their octet configuration and duplet configuration. Is it okay? So these elements which I am going to tell, representative elements, they want to get the, or they will try to get the configuration of inert gases. These representative elements try to get the configuration of inert gases. Observe, S block 1A, 2A, first group, second group. P block 3A, 4A, five A, 6A, 7A, excluding inert gases. Excluding inert gases in P block, remaining five groups. Those are 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 1, 2, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These 7 groups are combinedly called representative elements. These 7 groups, 2 from S block and 5 from P block. 2 from S block and 5 from P block. They want to get the configuration of inert gases. This total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These 7 groups, they want to get the configuration of inert gases. Meaning of that one, they want to represent like inert gases. That's why these elements are called representative elements. Okay, now once again, what are the representative elements? Two groups from S block and five groups from P block, excluding, out of six groups, excluding inert gases, remaining five groups are there. Along with these two, total 7 groups are there. Okay, these are called representative elements. And why those are called representative elements chemically, I told for you. I hope you are clear. Now, general outermost electronic configuration of representative elements equal to NS122, NP126, 125, sorry. This is 5 only. NS122, NP125. If you take only S block first group, only we will take NS1. Second group, NS2. Like that, NS2, NP1, NS2, NP2, like that up to NS2, NP5. Okay, ma'am? This is about representative elements. And our second type is inert gases. Out of total periodic table, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. These elements, they will not react with others. These are all highly non-reactive. In chemical terms, non-reactive is nothing but inert. These gases are highly inert towards other elements. That's why these are called inert gases. Because in outermost shell, they have duplet configuration and remaining helium has duplet configuration and remaining elements contain octet configuration. Outermost shell containing 2 electrons is called duplet configuration and outermost shell containing 8 electrons is called octet configuration. So these elements which contain these duplet configuration or octet configuration are highly stable and they won't undergo reaction with others. That's why these are called inert gases. This group comes under P block ma 18th group. Previously we have seen 1, 2, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. These are all coming under representative elements and this 18th group alone it is called inert gases. Okay, shall we go to next type? Next type is transition elements. Strictly speaking, we have a particular definition for transition elements, that is, the D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell configuration. The D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell configuration in their elementary state are in their stable oxidation state. Are called transition elements. Once see the definition once again. The D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell configuration. These are all belonging to D block only, but the D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell, that means completely filled D subshell must not be there in their elementary state. That might be in elementary state or in their stable oxygen state, are called transition elements. For example, let us consider zinc. Zinc electronic configuration is argon 4s2 3d10. Argon 4s2 3d10. Observe, this has completely filled configuration. Actually, transition elements should contain incompletely filled configuration. Zinc has completely filled configuration in elementary state. It is not in combined state, na? That is called elementary state. Okay. Let us check that stable oxygen state of Zn is Zn plus 2. Zn plus 2 configuration is argon 4s0 3d10. In the stable oxygen state also, zinc ion contains completely filled configuration only. It doesn't contain, see, whether it is elementary state or stable oxygen state, anyone, if it contains incompletely filled configuration, then zinc is belonging to transition element. But here, zinc contains completely filled configuration in elementary state as well as in its stable oxygen state also completely filled configuration only. That's why zinc is not transition element. same like that cadmium also, because that is belonging to same group only. Zinc, cadmium, mercury. This group number is 2B. This group number is 2B. This group is not included as transition element. These are only D block elements. The D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell configuration in their elementary state or in their stable oxygen state are called transition elements. Zinc, cadmium, mercury, those are not transition elements. Those are belonging to D block elements only. Okay, see. This group, 2B, that is 12th group. According to long form of periodic table, 12th group. This group is not included in transition elements. Remaining 9 groups, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper. These 9 groups are included in transition element. 3 to 11 groups. Now, which are coming under transition elements? For example, let us consider copper. Copper will show some exceptional configuration, argon 4s1 3d10 in its elementary state. In its elementary state, copper has completely filled configuration, completely filled D configuration. Are you getting my point? In its elementary state, copper has completely filled D configuration only. But it is belonging to transition element because in its stable oxygen state Cu plus 2 means 2 electrons must be removed. 2 electrons must be removed. Then 1 electron from 4s and 1 electron from 3d. Then it will be 4s0, 3d9. Incomplete configuration only, na? Whether it is any one form in elementary state or in its stable oxidation state, it should show incompletely filled configuration, deconfiguration. That is called transition element. Now, Cu plus 2 is the stable oxidation state of copper. In that, incompletely filled configuration is there, na? 3d9. Only completely filled configuration, only 3d10. Remaining anything, 3d8, 3d9, these are all incompletely filled configuration only. So, copper is a transition element. Remaining elements normally itself in their elementary state they contain incompletely filled deconfiguration. That's why those are all examples for transition elements only. Okay, ma? I hope you are clear for this example. Zinc, why it is not transition element? That is, even though in elementary state or in its stable oxygen state, it doesn't contain incompletely filled configuration. D block elements with incompletely filled configuration, they will show some different characteristics with respect to D block elements with completely filled configuration. That's why only they kept these 9 groups. What are those transition elements? Now I will show. Before that, once again I am showing this definition. The D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell configuration in their elementary state or in their stable oxygen state are called transition elements. Now, what are the transition elements? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Total 9 groups. In D block elements, excluding zinc, cadmium, mercury, that means 12th group, excluding that one, remaining all groups are coming under, 9 groups are coming under transition elements. According to Mendeleev, these are 3B, 4B, 5B, 6B, 7B, These three are eighth group and this is 1B. 2B is not included in transition element. Okay, this is the information. And sometimes scientists will say that these transition elements contain chemical properties in between the chemical properties of S and P block elements. Because generally we will represent the periodic table like this one, S, P, D, F. This D is present in between S and P. Those chemical properties of these transition elements, chemical properties of these transition elements containing in between the chemical properties of S and P block elements. Like that also we can say these are transition elements, like that they got the name. Like that one explanation is there, but majorly the definition is this one. D block elements which contain incompletely filled D subshell configuration in their elementary state or in their stable oxygen state are called transition elements. Okay ma, next. Finally, we are remained with inner transition elements. F block elements are called inner transition elements containing lanthanides and actinoids. This is simple. These are called inner transition. Because why it is called inner transition? If you see the electronic configuration of F block, ma, they contain electrons present in 4F and 5F. Lanthanides contain electrons present in 4F. Actinides contain electrons present in 5F. Lanthanides is called 5F series. Sorry, 4F. Lanthanides is called 4F series and actinides is called 5F series. Now observe, 5D, 6D, these are transition. D block elements only, na? Except that zinc group, ma, zinc, cadmium, mercury group. Remaining all are transition elements only. So 5D and 6D. These are representing transition elements. These F block containing electrons present in inner shell of transition elements. This is transition element. This is inner shell of transition element. See, fourth is inner shell of fifth one. Fifth is inner shell of sixth one. So these F block elements are containing electronic configurations in the inner shells of transition elements. Inner shells of transition elements, and accordingly the electrons present in 4F and 5F only, they will show chemical properties. That's why these elements are called inner transition elements. Combinedly, both lanthanides and actinides are combinedly called as inner transition elements. Okay ma, why it is called inner transition, it is clear. And what are the inner transition elements? F block elements are called inner transition elements. General electronic configuration for F block elements, how did we write? Like that only here also, same general electronic configuration we can write. General outermost electronic configuration. Wherever we are writing everything, we are writing general outermost electronic configuration only. Configuration. Okay ma, so depending on chemical properties, see everywhere we have discussed with chemical properties only. Depending on chemical properties of elements, periodic table is classified into four types. Those are representative elements, inner gases, transition elements and inner transition elements. In a diagrammatic representation, if you want to show this S block, P block up to these five groups, these five groups and these two groups commonly called representative elements. Next, these are called inert gases. These are called transition elements, except this zinc cadmium mercury group, remaining all are transition elements. Then you can ask, what about zinc cadmium mercury? Those are coming under D block only, there is no separate name for that one, okay? And this F block is called inner transition elements. These are the four types according to chemical properties: representative elements, inert gases, transition elements and inner transition. Okay ma, this is the information about long form of periodic table. We have seen totally first periods and groups separately, we have seen second, depending on differentiating electron present in which subshell, periodic table is classified into how many types: S block, P block, D block, F block. Those four we have seen. Now, depending on chemical properties of elements, classification we have seen: representative elements, inert gases, transition elements and inner transition elements. All these are the informations about long form of periodic table. Okay, so this chapter heading is periodic classification of elements and periodic properties. Till now we have completed periodic classification, okay, and next part is periodic properties. What are those periodic properties? Periodic is nothing but when we arrange the elements in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, ma, now finalized with basic property atomic number. When we arrange the elements in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, we got some properties getting repeated. Okay, those properties, trends we are going to see along groups and periods. Those are called periodic properties. So what is our side heading? Next side heading: trends of physical properties of elements along periods and groups in periodic table. Trends of physical properties of elements along periods and groups in periodic table. First thing is, we want to know what are the properties we are going to discuss. After that, every property definition we have to know and how it is going to be varied in a group and in a period. Everything by topic wise, property wise, we have to see. Okay, ma? What are those properties and how they are going to be varied in groups and periods? We will start in next class. And in today's class, we have seen what about the classification and we have completed exactly periodic classification. Now we have started with periodic properties, trends. Trends of physical properties of elements along periods and groups in periodic table. We will start from next class. Okay, ma? That is about today's class. I hope you are clear. Thank you. Thank you all. Have a nice day.